There is more data produced today, every day, than at any other point in human history. This is very fertile grounds for AI development. You know, AI at its heart, it's a group of technologies that aim to analyze vast amounts of data and use them to find patterns, detect patterns, and draw inferences from these patterns. The better quality data there is and the more there is, the better it is for AI development. AI can then be used and leveraged in countless ways. At its heart, it's a tool to make software more useful and thus firms and society more productive. But there are also some truly revolutionary potential uses, such as in autonomous vehicles or in home voice assistants, for instance. You know, we do truly believe that adoption of cloud spurs adoption of AI and the other way around. There's a positive feedback loop going on here. The better internet connectivity becomes, the cheaper computing power becomes, the better the server infrastructure, the more firms will move to the cloud, and thus they will produce enormous data sets that will be available on the cloud. If this data is made open source, then it's really easy for AI developers to come along, use the data, and just, you know, try and develop better AI tools. And conversely, this allows them to develop better AI tools that can then be made part of standard cloud offerings, thus for spurring more cloud adoption. So there's really a nice positive feedback loop going on there. For long-term focused investors, we would recommend that they gain exposure to the accelerating pace of AI development through two industry subsegments. The first one, the most prominent one, is probably the integrated cloud vendors, cloud infrastructure vendors, which also have other core businesses, whether it is in digital commerce or search or core software or digital content. The reason why is that these dominant firms, the large tech titans or tech giants, what they're doing is that they're accumulating immense structured data sets, which they can then leverage through their AI assets to develop the best AI tools. So they will be prime movers in the quest for AI dominance. The second subsegment that we really like are more niche cloud software providers, which use AI to drive better analytics and insights for their customers and thus make their client firms more efficient. Well, you know, as in any other growth equity investment, AI-related firms and cloud computing-related firms, they suffer from traditional investment risks, right? So for instance, rising US interest rates will affect the valuation of these growth firms. This is very clear. But there are some less traditional investment risks regarding AI. One you mentioned is automation, right? So that's probable. And scary outcome could be that, you know, greater AI automation, whether it's software or physical, leads to just unstructured mass unemployment over a short period of time. Now, short term, this looks less likely because probably AI in the interim will create new jobs, such as in software development. And, you know, some jobs requiring emotional intelligence, you know, they won't go away that easily. But yes, this is something that governments will have to be mindful of in the next few decades as more and more of the workforce is potentially automated. Another key risk that we look at, which might seem absurd at first, is the so-called superintelligence risk. So that's the risk that through some, by design or by a fluke, somehow AI developers come up with super intelligent AI, which we might have as human beings difficulty controlling or even understanding the motives of. This sounds ridiculous, sounds like science fiction, but this is something that academics and governments are very much looking into lately. But it's probably not for tomorrow.